all, congratulations to the captain and coach. Rahul Sinthetai, you took over this team, the junior team and A team. You always talked about process, and they have delivered actually. The results have come, they have won the World Cup. What kind of satisfaction do you get actually in this?
Yeah, firstly, thank you. Thanks a lot. I think the real satisfaction, in my opinion, isn't actually, like you said, the whole process that was followed over the last, 14, 16 months. I think, just the whole preparation and the planning that has gone into, I wouldn't say just necessarily, this World Cup, but just the planning and preparation of developing young under 19 players over the last 14, 16 months, I think is something that that I think is a good process that we've put in place. And like with everything else, you've got to keep refining it and keep getting better at it and keep improving on that process. So really, from my thing, really happy for this 15 boys that, get to be get to wear a World Cup medal, get to win a World Cup, because I think they thoroughly deserve it. They've put in a lot of hard work. There's been a lot of sacrifices over the last year by all of them. And just the way that they played in the World Cup, the way that they gelled as a unit, I think things like that give you a lot of satisfaction. The quality of cricket that they played, the way they executed, was absolutely brilliant, even under pressure. When we found ourselves under pressure in a few games, we always found people who stood up and delivered. I think these are the kind of things that give you a lot of satisfaction. The work put in by the support staff, the quality of people that we had in our support staff here was absolutely brilliant. So that was again something that gives me great satisfaction, that we put together a really good team of people that helped these boys. Just the support that we got even from just people outside of it, selectors, the NCA. I think all of it, I think it was great teamwork. The work from the guys behind the scenes at the BCCI in setting up games, setting up series. So I think when you have a tournament win like this and when you get a cup like this, I think it's really a good reflection on a lot of the teamwork and a lot of stuff that happens. And I think that gives me a lot of satisfaction.
Rahul, just one more question. You have played at this level also before you came into national team and all. Can you tell us, after 25 years, these under-19 boys, are they in a better position to understand the game better than what you were there actually? Because of so many things, about the exposure, the television, they get a chance to play so much, the support staff and all.
Yeah, I think, you can't even compare generations. I was in the World Cup when I was playing under-19. I remember I just played under-19 series. We played two test matches against a visiting New Zealand team. Quantity of cricket that these boys play is incomparable. The kind of support staff, the kind of professionalism and help that these boys have got is much better than, honestly, what I got when I first played for India, without a doubt. So that's how far things have changed. There's no doubt that this generation of players is, extremely fit. They're extremely, sort of aggressive. They play a really good, positive brand of cricket. They're just more worldly wise in a lot of ways than I think we were, a lot more confident as well. I think that's really good signs of sort of exposure and opportunities that they've been given.
Rahul and Prithvi, doganchai abhinandan. Prithvi, maza prashna tula hai. Individual achievement cha anek moments tujha life madhe aalya. 20th November 2013, 546 inning against St. Francis DICC. Ranji debut madhe 100, Duleep debut madhe 100. World Cup win kiti different hai ani kiti jasta anand hai tyacha, karan it's a team event.
खूप आनंद होतोय, कारण की जेव्हा आपण भारतासाठी खेळायला जातो खूप प्राऊड फिलिंग होतं. आणि स्कूल मॅचेस खूप खेळल्या आम्ही, तिकडे खूप रन केलं. मग रणजी ट्रॉफी, 16 स्टेट 19 स्टेट रणजी ट्रॉफी. पण जेव्हा आपण इंडियासाठी रिप्रेझेंट करतो तेव्हा ते अलग डिफरंट फिलिंग असतं. तर ऑब्व्हियसली खूप चांगलं वाटतंय, खूप प्राऊड आहे मला. आणि परत वर्ल्ड कप आम्ही परत आणलंय भारतासाठी. आणि सगळ्यांनी खूप मेहनत केलेली आहे, लास्ट मोर दॅन 1 इयर सगळ्यांनी खूप मेहनत केली आहे. प्रॅक्टिस मॅचेस, प्रॅक्टिस मॅचेसमध्ये आणि सगळे सपोर्ट स्टाफ पासून सगळे मुलं, लाईक 15 बॉईज सगळे, म्हणजे लास्ट इयरपासून खूप मेहनत करतायत ते. आणि त्याचाच रिझल्ट आम्हाला या वर्ल्ड कपमध्ये जसं प्लॅन केलेलं, जसं मीटिंग्स मध्ये प्लॅन करत होतो आम्ही स्ट्रॅटेजीज आणि तेच होत होता आणि चांगलं एक्झिक्यूट केलं ग्राउंड वर जाऊन ते आणि म्हणून आय थिंक बिकॉज ऑफ ऑल दोज थिंग आम्हाला नो वर्ल्ड कप जिंकायला मिळेल.
By everyone, as in, what can be or should be done in order to help them make the transition better?
So I think one of the things that these boys, I think the great thing about this World Cup is that they've had, so many experiences. I think they've got, as kids, they've had experiences that, hopefully should hold them in good stead for a lifetime. The fact of playing in an ICC tournament like it, in a high-pressure tournament, televised games, actually going up to the final and actually playing a high-pressure final. And, some of the boys did comment to me that the final did feel different to them than in some of the other games. And I kind of showed, I don't think we played our number one game in the final. We played it maybe in the semifinals and the quarterfinals, but, we got the result we needed. But, just the fact that they played a final, meant that that's an experience for them. Just the fact that they came to Bombay Airport and they saw the excitement and the noise and the people around them, I think is another experience. Coming here and fronting up to you guys and seeing this is another experience for them. So I'm glad that they've had the opportunity, to have these experiences and they've had the chance to have these extra experiences because they won. So that's really for me, from my point of view, the plus point. But like you rightly said, I think the challenges and the hard work really start from here. We've had a couple of conversations with them about it. It was actually quite interesting for me, while we were in the World Cup, they would show actually the reruns of some of the earlier finals. And they showed the rerun of the 2012 final. And as I was watching the rerun of the 2012 final, I just sort of went back onto the web and started checking up on a few things. And it was interesting because the 2012 final featured India and Australia. The result of the final will tell you that India beat Australia. 6 years down the line, only one of those boys has played a couple of one-day games for India. Four or five of the Australians have gone on to play for Australia. More of their guys have played first-class cricket. The debatable point is who actually won that final, if you look back 6 years later, right? So I think those are interesting chats to have. Those are conversations to have. And like I said, I hope that, from this bunch of boys, the talent is there, the ability is there. It's just a question of them now being, managed carefully, for them managing themselves, learning how to deal with, I think, the pressure. And like you said, the expectation that's going to come with now being Indian under-19 champions, being known players, it's not going to be that easy for them, at least for a short period of time, to play domestic cricket, without somebody talking about this performance or highlighting this performance or the expectations that come with this. So I think that's again a good learning and a good challenge. But like you rightly said, the hard work begins for them, and I think it begins for us as well as to how do we manage these boys over the next few years. That even if a lot of them don't go on to play for India, which it can happen. It's not easy to get into the Indian side. It depends on the number of people who are there. If the guys who are performing, it's difficult to break in at times. But at least if they go on to have successful first-class cricketers, and then from there on in, it becomes a stepping stone into international cricket.
Under-19 cricket in India, to play in the Kooch Bihar Trophy and other. So do you think that they should still be playing under-19 cricket after this, or should they just now be focusing on first-class cricket and making transition to their domestic?
Look, I think this is probably an answer that, I can give a personal view on. It's not necessarily the decision on whether they should be play or should be selected is obviously a BCCI decision. It will be an official decision. My view on this is actually quite well known and is quite clear. I feel that once boys are good enough, they need to go on and play men's cricket, especially the boys who are playing first-class cricket already. I mean, we've seen that with the last year's bunch of boys who could have been eligible for this World Cup, whether it was Washington, Mahipal, I think there was Arman, I think there was one or two other, I think there were five boys from the last World Cup. But we made a conscious decision not to pick them for this World Cup because, I genuinely felt that they'd be better off playing under-23 cricket and, senior men's cricket. Having some of these boys come back, and like you said, there are a few of them who could possibly come back and play the next World Cup, you know, will probably be good for the under 19 team, and it'll be maybe make our chances of winning a World Cup better. But I'm not sure it's the best thing for the boys themselves, and in the long run for Indian cricket, because one or two of them, without mentioning their names, and I think we might need to look at this on a case-to-case basis. There might be some boys who still will actually benefit playing in under 19 and might be a bit young and still maybe not breaking into their first-class sides, so they might actually benefit from playing here. But there are some boys who are already in their first-class teams. They already played Ranji Trophy in this group who are eligible next year. And my wish is for them to play at that level, even if, you know, they have a couple of tough years, and if they fail, I think they'll be better off for it than coming here and playing at an under-19 level, which they're clearly too good for. But again, that's not my decision. That's just my view. Okay.
This question is to Prithvi. Prithvi, we all know your struggle from the initial days. Like now, you're the captain of a World Cup team. What message will you give to a boy who's born and brought up in a humble background and who's not from the mainstream city? Like you also come from Virar.
I think it was not a, you know, it was really difficult journey for me. Starting where, you know, I used to live in Virar. So I think all credit to my dad, because he was the only one to take me all over, you know, used to take me for the matches, for practices. You know, it was far away from my home where I used to stay in Virar. It used to take like 2 hours, you know, 2-3 hours journey from the train as well. So it was really difficult for me, you know, on those days when I used to travel by trains and all those things. But I think, you know, if you work hard for something, you know, so I think in this past 2-3 years, you know, working hard for this, to play for under 19 cricket India and becoming the World Cup captain, I think it's really feels much, you know, I can't really express myself, but I'm really happy, and thanks to everyone for supporting me, you know, giving me blessings. And thank you to BCCI for, you know, and thanks to Selector as well, trust, keeping me a trust and giving this opportunity.
Well, the captain of the under-19 cricket team of India, who's just returned after winning the World Cup in against Australia. It's the fourth World Cup for the Indian under-19 cricket team, led and taught by Rahul Dravid, who was taking questions there from the media. We were just listening into the captain there speak about his own struggle to reach this point.